did you play the hockey when you were a child?
No, those hockey players gotta get up too early.
This guy's sport always was and always will be basketball. Back in 81, he was the star of what is still known to this very day as the JCC Miracle Game.
Oh, my.
The JCC was down by 24 points.
The bad news is we stand no chance of winning this game. The good news is it's Hanukkah, so you're all going to get presents tonight anyway.
Speaking of presents, our parents show up to all our games, even though we always lose. So I was thinking, maybe tonight we could try to win one for them, you know, as a gift.
The only way that's going to happen is if you take all the shots.
Well, if you guys don't mind...
It's okay with us.
Go for it. Let's win!
Okay, nice story. You can stop now.
No, go on. Why be? I'm mesmerized.
Can we just go? I'm cold.
I want to hear what happens next. It's like a fairy tale.
Unfortunately, this fairy tale doesn't have a happy ending. Davy was wondering where his parents were. Turns out they were on their way to the ball game when a truck hit a patch of black ice and swerved into oncoming traffic. Mr. and Mrs. Stone tragically couldn't get out of the way in time. I couldn't believe something that horrible could happen to a kid that nice. He walked right through that door and into foster home after foster home until his 18th birthday.
Oh my, you poor, poor boy. What in heaven's name did you do?
Let's just get off of this.
He didn't know how to handle it. What 12-year-old kid would? He basically shut down.
Hey. Davy, I'm so sorry. I don't know what to say.
There's nothing to say. My parents are dead. Happy Hanukkah. Now leave me alone.
That's the saddest story I've ever heard.
Hey, I'm out of here.
Maybe it's time you stop running from your emotions.
I'm not. I'm running from two crybabies who won't shut up about something that isn't any of their business.
You know, I read recently in Reader's Digest that people who let themselves cry when they're hurting are often stronger than the people who try to hold all their pain inside.
Did you read anything about a deformed referee who spends 35 years trying to win some stupid patch so he can pretend people actually like him?
Which month was that in?
Take that back.
Listen, if they have an award for the freakiest looking fraternal twins who no one even gives a about, you two are definitely winning. But that patch thing ain't ever gonna happen for you. Because the truth is, nobody in this town even knows you exist.
You're not welcome in my house.
Good, your house sucks.
Do you have to be nasty to everyone who tries to help you?
That's my problem.
He's just a no good Nick. And I am the real Koriste Yamaguchi.